celebration, smiles and imagination come to where the laughter never ends. We're Lalaloopsy!
Sleepless in Lalaloopsy Land. Time for bed, blanket. Is tomorrow school day at Bee's house? Not tomorrow, but the day after tomorrow. Now settle down and I'll read you your favorite bedtime poem. Close your eyes, lay down your head, all snug and cozy in your bed. Sweet dreams will take you with them soon, beneath the eye of the watchful moon. Fast asleep. Now it's our turn. Good night, sheep. Ooh, what was that? It's coming from the kitchen. And where's Blanket? Blanket! What are you doing here?
I don't know.
Let's get you back to bed.
Oh, good night, pillow.
Sweet dreams, blanket. Now I'm really ready for some shut-eye. What is going on with Blanket? I need to keep an eye on her, but I'm afraid I'll fall asleep, and it's so late. Hey, Dot stays up all night looking at the stars. Maybe she can help me.
We don't have much time left to get ready for school day, Owl. I hope Spot gets here soon.
Here I am, with a wagon full of art supplies.
Oh, thank you, Spot. Art is the very first subject I'm going to teach our little sisters on school day. First, 8 minutes of crayon time, then 10 minutes of finger painting, followed by 3.5 minutes of hand washing, then 12 minutes of sculpting clay.
But what if they use their crayons for more than 8 minutes?
Don't worry, I'll make sure they stay on schedule.
Well, you're the teacher, Bee. I'm sure you know what you're doing.
Thanks for coming over, Dot. Sorry it's so late.
Not late for me. I'm up every night watching the stars.
Well, tonight I need your help watching Blanket. She keeps waking up in different parts of the house, and I need to figure out how she does it.
Sounds like a challenge, and I love a challenge. I brought some special equipment.
Wow, Dot, thanks. But I don't know if we'll need all this. Blanket's right over there.
Oh, I've never observed something so close before. How exciting!
I just hope I can stay awake. If I fall asleep, please wake me up.
Will do. Let's set up right here so we don't disturb Blanket.
Great idea. What do we do now?
Now we watch. And wait.
I'm awake. What's happening?
Nothing yet.
Pillow, look!
I was just resting my eyes.
Blanket's getting out of bed.
Blanket, what are you?
Shh. Let's see where she goes.
Yeah.
explains everything. Blanket is sleepwalking.
Now, should we put the red crayons next to the red paint and the red chalk? Or should all the crayons go together and all the paint together? So many choices.
I just throw all the crayons into my wagon.
And Crumbs baked us these healthy snacks for snack time. I just have to decide which flavor of muffin would go best with each student activity. Now, does Bran Muffin say art, or does it say recess?
Thanks for your help, Dot.
My pleasure, Pillow. Good night, and good luck with the sleepwalking.
Sheep, I know exactly how to fix Blanket sleepwalking. Because if I know anything, it's how to get a good night's sleep. First off, it's really hard to get out of bed when you're snuggled up in a comfy blanket.
Too fuzzy, too buttony.
This one's just right, filled with extra soft feathers. Here you are, Blanket.
Ooh, it's so soft.
Isn't it? But wait, I have even more sleepy time tricks up my pajama sleeve. In order to have a restful sleep, you need the perfect cuddle buddy. And these are all my favorites.
Huh?
Oh, Sheep, you're my very favorite cuddle buddy.
I know just what Blanket needs, Sheep.
All of them! Here you go, Blanket. These cuddle buddies will keep you company while you sleep.
Can Little Sheep come to school with me?
She can't, Blanket. But she'll be waiting for you when you come home.
Oh.
And now I have one more surprise for you. Guaranteed to make sure you stay in bed tonight. Here it is. Beds are for sleeping. Don't sleep on the shelf. Don't sleep on the floor. Don't sleep in the kitchen. And don't sleep by the door. Don't sleep while you're walking or wandering or sweeping. Please get back in bed, 'cause beds are for sleeping.
Don't sleep on the table. Don't sleep on the...
Healthy snacks divided by educational materials, plus two outdoor sessions of physical activity. Carry the one. Yes! According to my calculations, school day should go off without a hitch.
That's great!
Except for the one variable I can't control, the students themselves. I've got it! I'll create a student simulacrum.
A what?
A group of test subjects to practice my teaching methods on. And pets are the perfect test subjects. I can have a practice school day with them tomorrow before the real school day. What do you say?
Oh, the story must have made me fall asleep too. I should be quiet so I don't wake up Blanket.
Oh no! Blanket, where are you? Sheep, we need to find Blanket.
Huh?
Sheep, I don't know what to do. Blanket is still sleepwalking, and all my usual bedtime tricks didn't work. And is Blanket going to be school day tomorrow? I have to make sure she gets a good night's sleep. I need inspiration.
What's that?
A cowbell?
That's it! Come on, Sheep, follow that cow! Mary! Cow, wait up!
Oh, good morning, Pillow. We were just on our way to go berry picking. Care to join us?
Actually, I need to ask you a favor. Well, I need to ask Cow a favor. Do you have any extra cowbells I can borrow?
Cow has a very large bell collection. But why do you need to borrow them?
I'll explain on the way.
Welcome to school day, little sisters. I know you're not actually little sisters, you're pets, but I'm going to stick to my official teaching script. Now, our first scheduled activity today is art. Please use this paper and the crayons on your desk to color. And this is what your artwork should look like. Exactly like this. Zebra, the sun should be yellow, not blue. Mouse, please don't nibble on your paper. Oh, Owl, that's exactly right. Everyone, come look at Owl's drawing. Owl certainly is the teacher's pet.
What a great way to stop Blanket from sleepwalking. There's no way she'll be able to get out of bed without ringing a bell and waking up.
Exactly.
Is it nap time? Oh, look at the pretty bells.
It is your nap time, Blanket. Sheep? Cow? Have a good nap, Blanket. We'll be right outside. If Blanket gets up, we'll hear the bells ring as she bumps into them. Well, Blanket's nap time is over, and I haven't heard a peep. The bells worked. Let's go check on Blanket.
Oh, no!
Blanket's not in her bed.
Pillow? Over here.
Blanket's still sleepwalking. The bells didn't work. I'm going to have to think of something else.
Oh, Owl, yours is absolutely perfect. Who's ready for snack? Now, please remain seated as I... Oh, one at a time. Oh my, I planned 15 minutes for snack time. Well, I guess we can skip ahead to recess. Yes, Owl, you may be excused. I'll meet you outside. This is not how I calculated the day would go.
We'll be right back with more bells. Enough so Blanket can't make a move without ringing one.
Thanks for your help, Barry.
Sheep, I sure hope more bells will help Blanket sleep.
What is it, Sheep?
A fence! You're right, that may just work for Blanket.
Barry, wait! I think I have an even better idea!
And that should do it.
Thank you, Barry. This fence should keep Blanket safe and sound and in bed. It's like sleeping in your very own fort. Have a good nap, Blanket! That fence should keep Blanket from getting out, just like Cow. That sheep! Oh no! Blanket's still sleepwalking!
Well, it was worth trying.
Barry, do you and Cow mind taking down the fence?
We can do that almost as fast as we put it up, can't we, Cow?
I need to figure out what's causing the sleepwalking in the first place.
And I think I know someone who can help.
Duck, duck, goose!
at all what I'd planned.
Hi, Bee. I was wondering if you had a book on sleepwalking I could borrow.
A book? I can help you with that. I'll be right back. Sleepwalking is so interesting, Pillow. It can be triggered by a variety of things, including stress and anxiety.
Stress and anxiety? That's it! Thanks, Bee. I'll be sure to bring this book back when I'm done with it.
Well, at least something went right today. Oh, today is a disaster. How am I ever going to make school day run smoothly?
Ooh, is that a new bedtime storybook?
No, it's a book about sleeping.
I like to sleep.
So do I. But Blanket, is there anything you don't like to do? Something that makes you nervous?
I don't think so.
Maybe you're anxious about something.
Nope.
Really?
May I take a nap now?
Sure. I'll keep an eye on you. Maybe there's more in Bee's book. Sleepwalking runs in families.
Well, I've never sleepwalked.
Sleepwalkers are not aware of what they're doing.
A good nap.
Hey, where am I? How'd I get up here?
Oh no, now I'm sleepwalking?
Bee's book was right. Sleepwalking does run in families.
Sheep, how am I gonna get down?
Sheep, do you hear that? It's Cow. Barry and Cow must be nearby. Go run and ask for help.
Pillow! How did you get up there?
I don't remember. I was sleepwalking.
More like sleep climbing.
Can you help me get down?
Good thing we brought this ladder.
Thank you both. Now I have to go find my little sister Blanket.
Today didn't go as I planned, Owl. In fact, nothing I planned worked out. It's okay, Owl. School's out. Go play with your friends.
Bee, I'm looking for Blanket. Have you seen her?
Not today. Hey, did my sleepwalking book help?
Not yet.
Well, I hope Blanket sleeps well tonight, since she has school day tomorrow. Is she excited?
I'll bet she is. That must be why Blanket is sleepwalking. She's excited about school. It all makes sense now. Blanket was asking about school. She was making a sandwich for her lunch. She was packing her backpack and putting on her jacket. Now I know how to solve Blanket's sleepwalking. Thanks, Bee. See you tomorrow. Blanket, are you here?
Blanket, Blanket, wake up. Pillow?
I have a very special bedtime story to tell you.
I love stories.
Are you ready? Once upon a time, there was a little girl named Blanket.
That's my name.
That's right. And Blanket was excited about going to school for the very first time. But she was also a little bit nervous, because she didn't know what to expect. But when she got there, she found all her little friends were there too. And they were going to do all kinds of fun activities together, like draw pictures and eat snacks and play outside.
School sounds like fun.
It is fun, and there's nothing to worry about.
What happened to Blanket in the story?
Well, she learned a lot at school and made her big sister very, very proud.
Owl, I've deduced why school didn't go as planned yesterday. My equations were missing one important factor, the uncertainty principle. The only thing we can expect is the unexpected. But now that I know exactly what to expect, I can plan for it. I don't have to do everything by the book. I can go a little off book too, if I need to.
Blanket, we don't want to be late for school day.
Coming. I'm ready to go. I can't wait.
Very good. I see you have your book bag and your lunch. We're all set.
Bye, little sheep. Don't worry. I'll be back soon.
So, Blanket, are you still feeling nervous about your school day?
Nope. School is going to be fun. We'll learn things and have snacks and play outside at recess.
Exactly.
Welcome, students. Come inside. I have a really fun day planned.
Sheep, I don't want to hear the words sleep and walking together ever again. The end.